Bubbles on the sky, magic on the people, living for today.
Imagine this, no heaven, it is easy if you try. No hell with us above us on the sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Thank you, Mark. Dear friends, good afternoon. Salibonat. Salam alaikum. Khotso. Jambo. Bon dia. Shalom. Konnichiwa. Bonjour. Kia ora. Namaste. I am deeply honored to have been chosen to be among those speaking to you today. And I especially thank Liverpool Hope and Vice Chancellor, Professor Gerald Fillet, for the invitation and for daring to create this amazing happening, this big hole, Young Leaders Congress. As I look at your faces, I ask myself, what is the story that lies behind your smiles? How much joy is in your heart? And how much pain is there? What do you imagine for yourself? What is the world of your dreams? Because of my faith, I also like to ask the question, what is God's dream for the human family and for Mother Earth? During this week we will spend together, we will all have the opportunity to experience our common humanity in its diversity and in its commonality. We like to say at our Institute for Healing of Memories that all people have a story to tell, and every story needs a listener. I have no doubt that there will be many wonderful, challenging, and inspiring presentations that you will not forget. However, even more importantly will be the times that you sit and listen to one another's stories with open minds and open hearts, especially the other who is different from you because of their color, gender, disability, sexuality, class, nationality, ethnicity, and whether they come from a country that profits from war or suffers from war. If those hard conversations do not in some way change you, you wasted your time and your money coming here. Allow me to share one or two snippets of my story. A long time ago, I arrived in South Africa as a young priest when the evil system of apartheid was doing its worst damage. The day I arrived in South Africa, I stopped being a human being and I became a white man. I joined the liberation struggle. to recover my own humanity in solidarity with black people struggling for their fundamental human rights.
Profit from war, respond
born with hard hearts to the largest number of refugees in human history. Those fleeing hunger and war are then rejected by the two wealthiest regions of the world. Refugees are washing up on beaches in the Mediterranean. Africans are bought and sold as slaves in Libya today.
Live in harmony with Mother Earth.
the very ones who have suffered genocide, desolation, and humiliation. In 1948, the world adopted the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. In 2018, 100 years since the end of the First World War, and 100 years since the birth of Nelson Mandela, following on the suffragettes, those who fought to end slavery, those who campaigned for peace in Vietnam, the whole world united to end apartheid. In 1976, school children were shot in the streets of South Africa and then mobilized to end apartheid. In the United States, the young people are marching for our lives to end gun violence. My dear friends, now is the time for world peace, for the swords to be turned into plowshares. Today, we need a new worldwide peace movement. It is this generation that must insist on total nuclear disarmament, not just on the Korean Peninsula, but also in the United States of America and the United Kingdom, and. In South Africa, we renounce our nuclear capability, and so you can too. We're all part of the world of Facebook and Instagram and WhatsApp and Twitter, the communication revolution. Now it is time for a revolution of generosity and compassion, for conflict resolution and healing of memories. Or as Pope Francis speaks about, a tsunami of mercy and kindness. Let our arms factories transform themselves into creating tools for agriculture or new vaccines, or let them go bust. Let every government create ministries of peace, conflict resolution, and interfaith dialogue, as each year we shrink our defense budgets. Let every school child be encouraged and taught how to develop empathy and compassion. Let all places of learning be places where there is head learning and heart learning and soul learning. With your permission, I would like to end on a very personal note. In 1990, I received a letter bomb from the apartheid regime that was supposed to kill me. Through the years, I have often asked myself, why did I survive a bomb that was supposed to kill, unlike so many others who also deserve to live? My wounds bear witness to what evil and hatred and racism does, disfiguring and destroying. Stronger than evil and hatred and death are are gentleness, kindness, compassion, justice, love, and light. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will be as one.